You're watching The Rundown. I'm Hari Sreenivasan. We're joined by our friends at Politico, Craig Gordon from the newsroom there. Of course, let's talk a little bit about healthcare. Thanks for joining us today.
Anytime.
So you think the White House has T-shirts made up with 216 written on them?
Look, they're going to pull out every single stop. We've been hearing about the president offering to go to districts or stay away from districts, I suppose. The DCCC, the House fundraising arm, giving money or withholding money. So there is a lot of arm twisting going on pretty much as we speak, as Nancy Pelosi tries to get to that magic number of 216 votes.
Now, you had an interesting story about five different ways that the bill could pass and five different ways that it couldn't. One of those kind of swing opportunities or possibilities was the Bart Stupak coalition, whether they hold or not. Is the White House think that they can chip away at some of those votes that Bart Stupak says will stay no votes?
They do. Stupak claims to have about a dozen members who will vote against the House, the Senate version of the abortion language, which is, they view it a little bit not as tough as the language that Stupak himself got inserted into the House bill. Quite honestly, Pelosi and the White House don't believe him. They don't think he's really got 12 people that are willing to vote no on, you know, essentially killing the entire health reform bill simply over the issue of abortion. They figure the number's more like a half a dozen. That's a number that's more manageable to them, that they could pick off six votes here or there versus 12 votes. It's actually one of the great open questions in Washington right now. It's a little bit wonky, but it's true. It really comes down to mathematics. Can she get all the way to the number 216? If Stupak has 12 votes, that'd be pretty hard to do. If he's only got six, she could probably pull it off, and that's really the question that the Democrats are trying to figure out right now.
How does the White House try to tackle that kind of larger philosophical question of please stay with us, this is really important, think bigger picture, versus all these members of the House who are looking, you know, right down the barrel of their constituents come November?
I think the White House is sort of making two arguments to folks right now, and one is, do you want to be the person who votes, you know, the last vote no that kills health reform? You know, we've been trying to get this in this country for more than 100 years, really, or 50 years at least. And, you know, do you want to be that person that says, nope, we're not going to reform the health insurance system for Americans? That's a pretty tough decision for people to make, kind of almost asking people to look themselves in the mirror and say, like, am I ready to take that vote? The second part for a lot of these members, Pelosi got 220 yes votes last time, 219 Democrats, and basically saying to those folks, like, you've already voted yes once, so you're on the record supporting basically the same bill, the same rough ideas. You know, why wouldn't you support it a second time, or else run the risk of, you know, being a flip-flopper? We all remember John Kerry, how much grief he took for that famous line in 2004, you know, I voted for it before I voted against it. Well, that's what a lot of these House members who might switch their votes would be kind of facing. So they're a little bit, you know, they're in a very tough spot. And the Democrats, the leadership and President Obama are using all the tricks and all the, you know, pulling out all the stops. But those are the main two arguments, I think, that some of these wavering Democrats are hearing right now.
And finally, what's the messaging right now with conservatives or Republicans? Right now on talk radio, you start to hear this argument that what's about to happen is unconstitutional, and that really that if this thing passes, that people should be jailed.
I mean, the Republicans are sort of making a lot less of a, what you might say is like a substantive argument on health reform is good or bad or up or down, but more now focusing on the process, which I think by any account has been a little unpleasant to watch. Keep in mind, the House voted for health reform in November on a Saturday at 11 o'clock. The Senate passed it on Christmas Eve morning at 9 a.m. And the House now is possibly going to do this thing called a self-exacting rule, where basically they would deem that they have voted the Senate bill into law even without taking a vote on it. Now, you know, I took an eighth grade civics class that said usually you have to pass a law by taking a vote in the House and a vote in the Senate. They're trying to get around that. Again, the Democrats say, well, it's been done before, different things, line item veto. But come on, we're talking about 1/6 of the U.S. economy hanging on this vote. I think that would be a very tricky sell for a lot of Democrats to take back to voters and say, again, it's a variation on the Kerry line. You know, I voted for it without voting for it. So I think the Republicans are trying to make some hay on that, and I think they might actually be able to.
All right. Craig Gordon from Politico, thanks so much for joining us today.
Sure thing.
You're watching The Rundown. I'm Hari Sreenivasan. Stay with us.